you've heard of Google Glass and Samsung smartwatch, we are entering a world of wearables. Here at the Consumer Electronics Show, there are lots of wearable devices, so I figured, why not wear myself out? This guy here is the Autographer. It's a wearable camera. And what's cool about it is the sensors inside tell it if the light has changed or if I've changed my speed, and it can take new pictures when I've made those changes. Now this one is the iSleep, which measures heart rate variability. It costs $75, $10 additional for the app. What's cool about it is it knows when I'm ready to work out. If I did a heavy workout the day before, not that I have, it'll say, hold on a second, wait another day for your big workout. Next up, we got the SenseGiz, which isn't on the market yet. It measures fitness, it measures your sleep, but it's also got a little emergency button, which I can push, or if I fall, it's going to alert via GPS somebody that I'm in trouble. For example, we set it up so it will text our producer, Micah, if I get into some hot water. All right, next up we've got the Philip. This is for kids, or for their parents, depending on how you look at it. It's for 5 to 11-year-olds. It costs $199, $10 additional per month to place calls to your parents from this, or to have calls from your parents to this. But also you can create this GPS safe zone, so if the kids go outside of the safe zone, you can send them a text to say, where the heck are you? Okay, now on my left wrist, I've got the Basis, which is wearable health. This is measuring things like blood flow. It's even measuring how sweaty I get. It's $200. And then over on my right wrist, I have the Fitbug. This little fella costs $50, but they encourage you to buy so-called kick plans, 12-week programs to help get you in shape. Whew, talk about getting in shape. I'm feeling a little worn out.